Ακολουθεί η ομάδα MELD. Το 2010 η Καρίν Βέμπερ και η Ιβόν Σενούφ ίδρυσαν μαζί το MELD, μια διαδραστική παγκόσμια πλατφόρμα τέχνης για να παράγονται και να παρουσιάζονται πρωτοποριακά έργα τέχνης ενσωματωμένα στα ζητήματα και τις συνέπειες της κλιματικής αλλαγής. Έχουν δουλέψει ποικίλα project κάτω από την ομπρέλα του MELD, ένα από τα οποία στη συνεργασία με το Γάλλο καλλιτέχνη JR. Μετά από μια επιτυχή πρώτη ομαδική δράση στην Αθήνα τον περασμένο Οκτώβριο που ονομάστηκε Μάτια της Αλήθειας, οργανώνουν αυτή την περίοδο μια παγκόσμια δράση που ονομάζεται Be the Change, γίνει η αλλαγή, με 17 συμμετέχουσες χώρες από όλο τον κόσμο.
Since creating MELD, we've been following French artist JR's work for the last few years. So last year, he won the TED Prize and we jumped at the opportunity to get involved with his work. He's known for taking large-scale black and white photographs and posting them in various outdoor spaces around the world. And his wish was to turn the world inside out and invite individuals and groups around the world to do their own action. This is a project that he did in 2007 called Face to Face in Israel and Palestine. He took pictures of both Israelis and Palestinians, each doing the same job, and posted them as diptychs on both sides of the Israeli and Palestinian wall. In 2008, he did another project called Women Are Heroes in the favelas of Brazil. As you can see, he managed to paste his photos against a lot of the houses in the favelas, which meant he had to really talk to all of the citizens in the community and tell them about the project and his work in order for them to want to participate. His whole process is about community participation.
A couple of years ago, while we were working on a project in Athens about water and departing of the central river of Athens, the Kifisos River, as we met the people living by the river, a recurring story kept on coming and over and over and over. This was the story of the children of the traffic light. Around 700 children were abducted from Athens at the dawn of the Olympic Games, and we created the action Eyes of Truth to honor these children.
We were so moved by this action, and we really wanted to pay homage to these children. So via an open call, we invited Athenian photographers to take portraits of children from both privileged and unprivileged social backgrounds. Then we, too, posted them as diptychs on a wall in Gazi, actually. What we realized, and which is often the case, is that it was so much about the process, the way the photographers interacted with the children, their parents. They became bridges between the different communities, from Kenyans to Georgians, Albanians, Peruvians. It showed Athens as a true melting pot.
As we finished the project, that was certainly not enough, and we decided to go global, and we contacted Monica Lozano in Juarez, Mexico, because her action was absolutely amazing. They covered the Rio Grande, which separates El Paso, Texas, and Juarez, Mexico, with 1,000 portraits of Juarenses, and that led us to Be the Change.
So through social media, we had a better ability to speak with various other leaders around the world. We got 17 cities on board with almost 50 leaders and basically decided to create a global action called Be the Change. It was so much about the collective energy and kind of engaging people to become more creative and to join forces. So starting in December, we started getting organized. Between 50 and 70 leaders, I think, we had on board. And basically, even though each city was going about their action their own way and their own process, we had to unite as a collective action globally in order to push the project forward.
Via the Inside Out project, JR did a great gesture of generosity. Not only did he give us a platform where we had a project from the people to the people, but by imposing really strict guidelines where there was no branding, no self-promotions, he forced us to come out of the box. When we faced the project with no money and no help from the city and no help from any organizations, we thought we never would be able to do it. But guess what? All the cities gathered together their volunteers and we found the force in the streets. In Athens, it was absolutely amazing and overwhelming, the response we got by the volunteers. We launched an open call through Facebook. And I found in my house around 50 people I didn't know, that didn't know each other, and basically decided we want to change, we want to do something. We went to Monasteraki Square in the hottest days of Athens, and that did not stop any Athenians, not in the street, nor in the volunteers. We took more than 600 portraits, and now we're ready to post all over Athens.
So we're in the final stages of the project. Each country has taken their 250 portraits. They've uploaded them to the site in New York. There's an office in New York that prints all of the images. So they've all been printed and actually sorted. So the idea with this project is that we're all 17 cities, going to receive portraits from all of the other participating cities. So when we post these images on a wall, we're standing shoulder to shoulder. Not doesn't matter where we're from, but that we're all humans working for something larger than ourselves. The plan is to partner with an event called World Peace Day, which is on September 21st, so literally 2 weeks from this weekend. And many cities are going to go about it a different way. We wanted to do a symbolic gesture in the name of peace and really launch this action in a very positive way. Some cities might be writing the word peace in their own language. Other cities might be doing some sort of dance or music, but something really symbolic and positive to join forces with everybody. In Athens, we're going to be actually doing our action at the Kalimármaro, so that's going to be fantastic, obviously. And Saturday will be the global simultaneous posting. So all of the 17 cities will, on the same day, post each of their 250 portraits. In Athens, we're going to be starting at Panepistimos Avenue. We're going to post all 250. And once, you know, with all of the 30 volunteers from the previous posting, all of the people who've been supporting the project in Athens, which is growing by the day, which has just been so motivating, the idea is to literally dance our way up Panepistimos Avenue, sorry for my misunderstanding, to Omonia Square, where we're going to be having a block party with live music and dance. We're going to be projecting the images against a large wall in Omonia Square. This is a party for the people. This is an event for people to really engage with one another, to talk about their hopes and their dreams, and to inspire one another. I think that this is what we need right now. And I think this project, you know, Be the Change, we had a dream 9 months ago. We wanted to unite the world through a photography action, through art. And the response has just been overwhelming. And I think anytime you really put your mind to something and you want to make it happen, you have to rely on everybody kind of working together. And it was such a collaborative atmosphere. Everybody was so helpful and inspiring that we hope you all join us in 2 weeks if you're in Athens and be the change you wish to see in the world.